Here we have a PanelView 550. This is one of the older style panel views that are still out there in the market. We have partially disassembled the unit so that we can show off some of the failures and some of the parts of the unit that we are going to be checking today. We will go ahead and power it on so you can see the failure that the customer was experiencing on their side. We have 24 volts of power going into the unit, and we will go ahead and gently flip it so you can see the screen. And there, you can see big pronounced lines going straight through the screen. And also, you can see how the contrast seems to be fading in and out. So we are going to go ahead and correct this issue. Before we start work, we'll go ahead and describe some of the parts to this unit. We have the power supply section. This will provide the power to both the unit and to the backlight. Here we have the communications interface board. And below, we have the processor board, which is underneath these two boards here. We will go ahead and remove this section here so that you can see underneath. And underneath the processor board, we have the LCD. Now, with the lines through the screen, there could be multiple causes. One of the causes could be the actual processor board itself. It could be the cable from the actual LCD to the processor board, if this cable is loose, or sometimes there is corrosion that gets inside the connector, and so forth. But in this case, we believe the LCD itself is bad. So we are going to go ahead and replace that and let you see the results. We have now replaced the bad LCD and we will dispose of it. And now we will go ahead and see how the new screen looks. We will hold our finger on the bottom right portion of the screen, which will take us into configuration mode of this device. And as you can see, the lines are gone, and now the image is nice and bright. So we will go into the configuration mode to test the touch functionality of this panel. We can now look at things like screen brightness, contrast, backlight timeout, and different video modes. But mostly, we want to test the touch screen functionality to make sure all portions of the touch are functioning. So afterwards, we are going to replace the overlay, clean the unit, and get it ready for shipping. Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to our channel.